In this screencast, you're going to learn about how state works in Compose, what are some of the APIs you can use, and how state and events should flow in your app. Let's take a simple example. The user can enter their name and a greeting should be displayed. So we have a text for the greeting and a text field for the name input. If you run this now, we see that nothing happens. That is because the text field doesn't update itself. It updates when its value parameter changes. To do that, we need to pass in a value that represents the state of the text field, and then update the state when the text field notifies us of the change. So let's introduce a local state that holds the name that should be displayed. To do this, we will use remember of mutable state of, passing in the default value for the text. Mutable state of creates a mutable state, which is an observable type in Compose. Any changes to its value will schedule a recomposition of any composable functions that read that value. So in our case, whenever the name state changes, the value displayed by text field will change too. Remember helps us preserve the state across recompositions. Otherwise, if we would just use mutable state of without remember, every time our hello content composable gets recomposed, the state gets reinitialized to an empty string. We can use the remembered value as a parameter for other composables, or even as logic in statements to change what composables are displayed. For example, we don't want to display the greeting if the name is empty, so we can use the state in an if statement. While remember helps us retain state across recompositions, the state won't be retained across configuration changes. For this, we'll have to use remember savable. Remember savable will automatically save any value that can be saved in a bundle. But if that's not the case, you can pass in a custom saver object. Right now, our composable holds its own state. This makes the composable hard to reuse, hard to test, and keeps the composable tightly coupled to how the state is stored. So we should make this a stateless composable, a composable that doesn't hold any state. To do this, we can use state hoisting. State hoisting is a programming pattern where you move the state to the caller of a composable. A simple way to do it is by replacing the state with a parameter and use functions to represent events. The parameter is the current value to be displayed, and the event is a lambda function that gets triggered whenever the state needs to be updated. In our case, we extract the name and the onValue change out of hello content and move them higher to a hello screen composable that calls hello content. Hello content has access to the state as an immutable string parameter, as well as a lambda onName change that it can call when it wants to request the state change. Lambdas are the most common way to describe events on a composable. Here, we're defining an event called onNameChange using a lambda that takes a string using Kotlin's function type syntax. We're using onNameChange, present tense, as the event doesn't mean that the state has already changed, but that the composable is requesting that the event handler change it. Like this, the state goes down from hello screen to hello content, and events go up from hello content to hello screen, making hello content more reusable and testable than before. But what if we want to use the name in other layers of our app? Maybe we want to save it in a database. The best way to do this is to use a view model that will store the state in an observable holder and handle events. So we can create a hello view model that extends the view model class. The view model holds and exposes the name in a live data, which then can be observed as state and passed to a composable. Like this, every time the value in live data changes, it will automatically trigger a recomposition of hello content. As the view model survives configuration changes, we don't need to do anything else to persist the UI state. Under the hood, observe as state will also remember the state for you, so it can survive recomposition. Then we also hoist the event handling to the view model. Like this, the view model is the one that updates the state every time an event happens. As the UI state can be changed from other layers of the app, like based on the response of a network call, the view model allows us to better encapsulate the state and create a single source of truth for the UI, which makes it less likely to create inconsistent states. Okay, let's recap. If your state is internal to a composable, make sure you use remember to persist the state across recomposition. Use remember savable to persist the state across configuration changes. Where possible, try to hoist the state to make the composable more reusable and testable. Finally, use the view model to hold an exposed state in an observable state holder like live data and to handle events. To learn more about state in Compose, check out the documentation and the code lab linked in the description below. Thanks for watching!